Before you begin, remove the access panel, front bezel, and rotate the hard drive cage up. Removal. Caution. Use care when disconnecting the wireless LAN antenna cables from the wireless LAN board. A damaged cable or connector can degrade performance. Disconnect the antenna cable from the wireless LAN board with a pair of small needle-nose pliers or tweezers. Pull the rear antenna cable out through the channel under the motherboard. Remove the rear antenna cable from the guide clips on the chassis. Press the release tab on the rear antenna cover and rotate the cover off of the chassis. Remove the Torx T15 screw that secures the rear wireless LAN antenna to the chassis. Lift and remove the rear antenna, guiding the cable through the hole in the chassis. Repeat steps 3, 5, and 6 to remove the front antenna. Replacement. Guide the rear antenna cable through the hole in the chassis. Replace the rear antenna onto the chassis, ensuring the guide pin is aligned with the cutout in the antenna. Replace the Towers T15 screw that secures the rear wireless LAN antenna to the chassis. Align the tabs on the rear antenna cover with the holes in the chassis and rotate the cover against the chassis until it snaps into place. Replace the rear antenna cable into the guide clips on the chassis. Guide the rear antenna cable through the channel under the motherboard. Repeat steps 1 through 5 to replace the front antenna. Reconnect the antenna connectors to the wireless LAN board. The antenna connectors are labeled 1 and 2 and should be connected to the corresponding 1 and 2 labeled ports on the wireless LAN board. Caution: use care when connecting the wireless LAN antenna cables to the wireless LAN board. A damaged cable or connector can degrade performance.